Inge.
Esto es bueno para el cuchillo, ¿no?
Sí.
Esta piedra
sí.
It's Sunday and I've been invited to a party, a picnic in the hills. Good fortune comes with a stranger at the feast. You never know who it might be. Because it's feria, Juan and Miguel are going to cook a special paella, the only dish the Andaluz male prides himself on being able to prepare. It's the only possible food for such an outing. We expect an army. Tarifa is now a windsurfer's paradise, and everyone has friends who has more friends. Squid and swordfish, and farmed langoustine. We're being spoiled today. And my pan macho from the bakery. That's masculine bread, bread with nothing taken away.
Ah, bueno, sí. ¿Y chorizo?
Chorizo para la brasa, para mientras hace la paella.
Eso bueno.
A paella should never be cooked indoors or served after sundown. And there are those who say it should never be cooked by a woman.
Sí.
So that leaves one half of us on washing up.
No sé, de mirar, a ver, la gente no me ha enseñado de una especie.
Sí.
Luego ya he sacado mi propia técnica.
¿Siempre te ha gustado hacer la cocina?
Sí, mucho.
¿Sí? ¿Y tu padre lo hizo con paella?
No.
¿No? ¿Tu madre?
Mi madre hace arroz. Paella no le gusta.
¿No?
When I lived up here with my family, we always followed local custom and went up into the hills on a Sunday, where we lit a fire and cooked a meal, a weekly taste of the full-scale rural pilgrimage. Grating the tomatoes. I've never seen that before. It's a good trick. We're making a tortilla with eggs and potatoes and chorizo to eat while the paella cooks.
Proper skin, not a plastic one.
No, not like
this.
Some people cut the potato into slices, others into chunks, others like a chip shape. But the absolute rule is that the potato must be fried absolutely soft before you add it to the beaten eggs and chopped chorizo. You need one egg per medium-sized potato.
En la eso brasa, ¿no?
Cuando se todo preparado ya, la tortilla, la patata frita y tal, se mezcla con el
huevo. Sí, se lo... Sí,
para
eso
que tú
sí.
Cómo se da la vuelta
eso,
a una buena tortilla
eso.
Española.
Eso.
You cut the langoustine firmly through the head, which kills it instantly. The langoustines are the star of the paella. You don't usually get them. Miguel went down to the fish farm this morning, and everyone is looking forward to them. When my own children were small, they used to find freshwater crayfish in the stream. If we were lucky, or we might find snails. Wild gathering is part of the fun of a paella.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very movable feast.
Buenísimo.
Sí. Eso tiene más color. Tengo
que ser
uno más chido. ¿Parece
macho? Eso ya no lo sé.
No, pero no lo podemos inventar.
Que canta otra vez lo mismo.
Siempre que vuelves a casa, me pillas en la cocina. Empadurnada en arena, con las manos en la masa. Niña, no quiero platos finos. Prepárame un gazpacho con pepinillo. Una botita de agua, mierda, Manolo.
There's chorizo and potatoes and pepper and garlic, and the potatoes are perfectly soft and cooked in olive oil. And there you go.
Uli, mamá.
Ahí vamos. Now we're going to take it over to the fire and cook it.
The skill is to match the volume to the size of the pan. The tortilla has to be thick to be juicy. Miguel comes from Granada, so he's laying out the cheese and chorizo, Granada style, on a slate tile, for while we're waiting for the food to cook.
Poppy.
Yeah.
Se va a achicharrar vivo, lo sabes, ¿no? Vete más lejos para dar la vuelta.
¡Ole!
Juan isn't convinced. He mightn't have done a better job. Everything goes in raw, and all the juices are absorbed by the rice. In this kind of cookery, you don't throw anything away which will add flavor. A paella is the culinary equivalent of an archaeological dig. It's cooked in a Roman-designed iron twin-handled pan, using olive oil from Roman-planted trees, Phoenician saffron, the rice of the Moors, a bit of pork from the Catholic kings, Mediterranean and Atlantic fish, New World vegetables.
Now it's going to change colour. It's very hot over here. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of...
Saffron, the stamens of a crocus, a beautiful color. Its perfume is supposed to make you sleepy. In goes the rice, one glass for each person. Two glasses of water for each glass of rice. It's amazing how a wine tumbler comes in handy. The langoustine will cook in the steam.
Está bien. ¿Y esto qué? Lentiscal. Eso, ole.
Topped out with a sprig of lentiscal. Much better than parsley.
Thank you.